In this video, we're going to discuss the fact that some fat accumulation is more dangerous than other. This information will help you minimize the risk of developing type 2 diabetes, high blood pressure, heart disease, and certain cancers. Welcome everyone, I'm Begonia. I'm a professor, dietitian, and nutritionist, and love to help you become healthier one week at a time. If you like this type of content and want weekly health information, click on the subscribe button below. Today we will learn different types of fats around the body, the two most common body types, the most dangerous fat, and how to actively get rid of this fat. Let's look at fat around the body. We have two main categories of fat, subcutaneous and visceral. Sometimes you may hear these two main categories of fat broken down further into brown, white, and beige fat. But for the purpose of this video, we will stick to these two major categories of body fat. You may also hear the term adipose tissue to refer to fat. Don't get confused, it's all the same. Most people think of fat as something bad. I just want to clarify that we cannot live and survive without fat. Fat in the body has a lot of functions that are crucial and essential to keeping us alive and healthy. Fat is not our enemy, as long as we keep it under control. Let's take a look at this picture. We have seven layers of skin surrounding our body. After the skin comes this yellow layer known as subcutaneous fat. But people just call it fat because it's the fat that is visible and the one usually people want to get rid of. Subcutaneous means underneath the skin. As you can see, it goes all the way around the body. Some places in the body accumulate more of this type of fat, primarily hips, legs, and belly. As our bodies accumulate fat from eating more than what we burn, we do not choose where the fat will be stored. Equally, when we lose weight, we do not choose where the body will get rid of that extra fat. Two, most common body shapes. Most people, when they start gaining weight, they either start gaining weight above the hips or below the hips. Physiologically, we can't choose or change this mechanism. When you start gaining fat weight, if you accumulate fat primarily above your hips, you have what is referred to as an apple body shape. If you accumulate body fat below your hips, this is called a pear body shape. Usually men tend to have apple-shaped bodies, while women tend to have pear-shaped bodies. Those with apple-shaped bodies have a much greater risk of developing major chronic diseases. Let's find out why and what can we do about it. The most dangerous fat. I have mentioned subcutaneous fat already. Let's look at the other type of fat. It accumulates in the abdominal area and is known as visceral fat. We also refer to too much weight in this area in the body as central obesity. Why is central obesity so dangerous? If we look at this diagram again, we see this red area here. That's a muscle layer, and it goes all around the body. In some areas, you'll see that it's thinner and some thicker, primarily depending on how much exercise you do and what type of exercise you do. But notice the central area of the body. That yellow accumulation is visceral fat. Unlike subcutaneous fat, visceral fat has nothing to contain it. On one side, it has muscle, on the other, major organs. It can freely travel throughout the body and get to our major organs like the heart, the liver, intestines, pancreas, and so on. This location is what makes visceral fat the most dangerous fat. Subcutaneous fat is not as dangerous because it's contained on one side by the skin and on the other side by our muscle. So how do you know if you have visceral fat or subcutaneous fat in your belly? It's super easy. Use the pinching method. Pinch your belly, and whatever you're grabbing onto is subcutaneous fat and a little bit of skin. You cannot pinch through muscle. So if you still have a lot of belly fat after pinching, that means that the fat is behind the muscle and it's visceral fat. And this is very dangerous. Let's see why. In recent years, we have learned that visceral fat doesn't just sit there and accumulate. It is a collection of living, breathing cells that release chemicals into our bloodstream and major organs. Visceral fat releases cytokines, which are proteins that trigger low-level tissue inflammation and insulin resistance. This increases our risk for developing heart disease, high cholesterol, strokes, and type 2 diabetes. Visceral fat also produces a precursor to angiotensin, another protein that causes blood vessels to constrict, blood pressure to rise, and this leads to hypertension or high blood pressure. Visceral fat also decreases your good cholesterol, or HDL, which alone increases your risk of building up fat in your arteries, leading to atherosclerosis and heart attacks. Studies have also shown that when you compare people with central obesity as compared to people accumulating fat anywhere else in the body, central obesity increases your risk for developing colon cancer, breast cancer, and dementia. Many factors increase visceral fat regardless of genetics. Eating too much, a lack of exercise, stress, drinking alcohol, a lack of sleep, and cigarette smoking, to name a few. The term beer belly refers to buildup of visceral fat due to drinking alcohol. Women also increase visceral fat accumulation after they reach menopause, unless lifestyle changes are incorporated. So how do we prevent and get rid of visceral fat? The good news is that visceral fat responds more efficiently to diet and exercise than fat found anywhere else, like the hips and the thighs. Here are approaches that work. 1, keep moving. If you haven't started yet, start exercising regularly. Exercise can help you reduce the size of your waist. Even if you don't lose weight, you will lose visceral fat and gain muscle mass. Engage in at least 30 minutes of moderate to high intensity activity 6 days a week. Be sure your intensity is not so easy that you can hold a normal conversation. You should push yourself a little harder if you want to lose visceral fat. The exercise that works best to trim visceral fat is aerobic activity, such as brisk walking, running, swimming, or cycling. Also includes strength training 3 days a week, whether exercising with weights or using your own body weight. Spot training, such as sit-ups, does not work to get rid of visceral fat. What is clear is this: diet alone will not be efficient and get it rid of this dangerous fat, so you have to incorporate exercise. 2, eat right. Choose more vegetables, whole grains, and legumes. Snack on fruit or vegetables, not fruit juice. Remove products that encourage belly fat accumulation, like sodas, smoothies, teas with sugar, candy, or fatty meats and bakery goods. Remove frozen dinners from your shopping list and encourage yourself to cook at home more often. If you go to restaurants, get in the habit of eating half of the meal you order and take the other half home, as restaurant serving sizes are often too large to begin with. 3, quit smoking. The more you smoke, the more likely that you will store fat as visceral fat. Drink less alcohol. This may be the one issue that is keeping you from losing belly fat. Every time you drink alcohol, more calories are stored as visceral fat, even if you're not overeating. 5, forget the quick fix. It does not exist. You may have heard of liposuction, but it doesn't work for two simple reasons. 1, liposuction removes subcutaneous fat, not visceral fat. 2, fat cells can grow indefinitely. So when you are overweight, you don't have more fat cells. You have the same amount. They are just bigger cells. When you lose weight, those cells have been shrinking at the same time that you've been losing weight. Liposuction isn't going to work because all you're doing is giving more room to the cells that are left there to increase in size indefinitely. So it's not a long-term solution, and it's a really expensive one. We've learned that where our fat accumulates does make a difference in our long-term health. It's clear that deep belly fat is the most dangerous, and that there are ways to control it. If you'd like specific exercise routines to help you lose body fat, please let me know in the comments below. I hope this video was of value to you. Remember to press the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for joining me. Until next time, cheers to your health.